blame game. We've all done it. I'm Brian McIntosh. This is The Daily Dose. We've all played the blame game. The blame game is that thing that we do as humans sometimes when things don't go the way that necessarily we wanted them to go. And a lot of times it has to do with decisions maybe that we've made or directions that we've gone. But it's really hard to say, God, I screwed that up. So instead, we naturally and humanly and completely understandably look for other things, people, or circumstances to say, this is why it didn't work out. And, you know, again, that is human nature. It's natural. Kids do it all the time. If you're a parent, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But the challenge with that is, as soon as you begin to play the blame game, here's what you do. You take away your own ability to affect change. Because if it's somebody else's fault, then that somebody else has to fix it. So you not only give away the responsibility or the blame, but you give away the power to make any difference or to make any change to whatever situation it is that you're uncomfortable with. That's why people, we all know people, right, that have a perpetual victim mentality, right? So they're always, you know, being victimized in some way. Somebody's always out to get them. It's always a conspiracy. You know, nothing's ever their fault, right? We all know people like that, right? Have you ever noticed, though, that those people never even make an effort, really, to change the circumstances in their lives? And it's probably because they feel powerless. And they feel powerless because they're so accustomed to giving away the authority or the power to affect any change in their lives. And they give it away through blame. See, if I'm overweight because my wife doesn't cook, you know, good foods or healthy foods, then I have to wait for my wife to have a change of heart before I can get skinny. Well, that's ridiculous. Because somebody would say, you know, if you really wanted to get skinny, you would go buy your own groceries, make your own meals, or do something different. You know, you have options. You have choices. You are not a tree. Right? You can move. All right? And that's all well and true. But it would be very easy to blame it on someone else. It would be very easy to say, hey, the reason why I'm overweight is because my job has me working 12 hours a day, and I have to eat breakfast and lunch and dinner on the go. Otherwise, I don't eat. And when you eat on the go, you eat unhealthy, and that's why I'm overweight. So it's my job's fault. But in reality, I could spend 30 minutes in the evenings instead of watching the 10 o'clock news packing my breakfast, lunch, and dinner with healthy foods that would keep me thin and fit. So you see, as easy as it is for us to give away responsibility, or in essence, to blame others, when we give away responsibility, we also give away the power to change whatever circumstance it is that we're unhappy with, that we want to blame somebody for. The only way that you have the power to fix whatever situation is in your life is if you own it. If you say, I did this. If you say, hey, I did this, then guess what? Now you can fix it. You can change it. In fact, you can do anything you want to do. So there's such an incredible internal power to taking ownership and to eliminating blame and getting out of the blame game and get back into control of your life. That's The Dose, guys. Make it a great week.